If you clicked on this video and said, Paul who? It's this guy who was seen destroying his bass on stage at a huge concert in what is probably the most iconic photo ever taken of a bass player. Now, I will fully admit that I had not listened to much of The Clash before I started working on this video, but I found that I really enjoyed it, like pleasantly surprised by how much I was enjoying The Clash. Paul actually has a pretty unique identity as a bass player, so let's get into how to sounding like Paul Simonon. First things first, let's go through Paul's gear and kind of get a sense of what we're working with so that we can replicate his tone on our Zoom B1X4. Guess what, guys? It's two things, and two things only. A P-Bass and an Ampeg SVT. Now, I know a P-Bass and an SVT is a super basic bitch setup, but there's a kind of a reason why it's such a popular combination. The P-Bass was the first commercially successful mass-produced electric bass, and the Ampeg SVT was one of the first adequately high-powered bass amps. To fill those big arenas just by yourself as a bass player, you had to have big equipment because you weren't going through the PA. The history of the Ampeg SVT is actually super interesting. I'd love to do a, what is the Ampeg sound a la Rhett Scholl. If that's a video you'd like to see, let me know in a comment down below. Anyway, we're getting really distracted here. Let's get back to Paul. Now, his utilization of the PSVT combo is a pretty balanced one. From an EQ standpoint, I'm not hearing a ton of low end, but I am hearing a lot of low mids, and there's quite a bit of roll off on the top end, so it's not like really trebly and bright. And despite The Clash being known as a punk band, there's not a lot of overdrive or bite in his sound either, which is really unexpected. One other little minor detail that I noticed when I was watching live videos of The Clash is that Paul tends to pluck a little bit towards the neck instead of directly over the pickup. It's a small detail, but it actually contributes quite a lot to his specific tone. Alright, so now that we've got all of our pieces together, let's go over to the Zoom and start building the patch. Alright, so for starters, Zoom has an SVT and an 8x10 cabinet, so we're just gonna start with those. Here's the dry signal. And then here's what it sounds like through the SVT in the cab. Out in front, I decided to stick the MB compressor just to smooth things out. It also lets us hit the amp a little bit harder. It's not overdriving it, but it does boost the overall level just a little bit. At the end of the chain, I've added this room reverb. It just kind of gives the sound a like subtle live feel. Punk really benefits from being a little bit rough around the edges, and I kind of feel like that's a nice texture for this kind of style. So that's all the pedals we're going to use for now. Let's see how this sounds on a song like London Calling. That sounds pretty good. Let's try this on another song. Let's do Rock the Casbah, which is actually a really fun bass line and you should learn it. Here's how that sounds. To me, that doesn't quite nail that tubby feel, so let's try a bass with flat wounds on it. We're talking. The flats kind of give it a more wooden quality, which I think is perfect for a couple of the songs in The Clash's catalog, like Train in Vain, Guns of Brixton, and Magnificent Seven all kind of have that vibe. Now, if you don't have a bass with flats on it, you can of course get a little closer by turning the tone knob most of the way off. Not all the way, but like two-thirds or a little bit more. Depends on how your bass reacts, but yeah, just play with the tone knob if you want to get it to a little bit more sounding like flats. Lastly, let's tackle Paul's insane fuzz tone on Should I Stay or Should I Go? Now, I couldn't find exactly what kind of gear he was using on this. Some people seem to think that it's a Boss OBD3, or maybe he was just overdriving a studio compressor, or using some kind of a gated fuzz. I couldn't find a definitive answer. If you know for sure, definitely let me know. What I ended up using for my patch was the Voodoo Drive, which is just an overdrive, but I've kind of got it set up for high gain, and it feels a little bit more like a gated fuzz would, and that's what this sounds like. Darling, you got to let me know. Should I stay or should I go? If you say that you are mine, I'll be here till the end of time. So you got to let me know. So there you have it, that's how to sound like Paul Simonon. If you'd like to download this patch and use it for yourself, you can do so by going to my Patreon. These patches only cost $1, and not only do you get this one, you get every single one I've ever done. And if you want to see how many that is, look at this playlist right here. That's every one of these I've done. There's quite a few of them there. If you do end up using this patch for anything, either tag me or use the hashtag HTSL, because I would love to see what you guys are doing. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, please do click this playlist. I've got a bunch of these in this series, and I would love it if you checked them all out. Do subscribe for more videos in the future, and I will see you on the next one. AMP out!